YouTube, my name is Mesa Sean, and welcome back to another Destiny 2 video. Alright folks, this is going to be a in-depth guide to Armor 2.0, or at least my experience with the playtest build over at Bungie Studios. Yeah, Bungie was kind enough to fly me out to Bungie Studios, get some hands-on time with Shadowkeep. So, goals for this video, I have them written down right in front of me. We're going to go over Armor 2.0, we're going to go over the benefits, my first impressions. We did have access to all of the different mods within the game, and my goodness, there are a gazillion of them. We also had access to the seasonal artifact mods, which are crucial when you're doing the ordeal Nightfall Strikes. You will see certain enemies cannot be stopped unless you guys really sit down and talk about who's going to put what mods on what characters, pieces of armor, or weapons especially, because some enemies, they're not going to go down unless you put a certain mod on them. And in the gameplay in the background, and I'm going to let the full thing run out at the end of the video, this is the 950 version of the ordeal, Nightfall Strike. And I was wrong in yesterday's videos, guys, when I went over Ariana's Vow, the new exotic hand cannon, and also covered a number of other things. It will be annotated on screen and linked in the description. I thought we did not finish the 950. It was a long day, guys, but we did get the 950 done. We'll go over some different sources, or known sources right now, to get these mods and collect them once Shadowkeep hits, and we'll talk about the different enemies that are in the ordeal Nightfall Strikes. We've got these new champions. We've got, in this particular one right here, the 950, we've got the barrier champions and we have the unstoppable champions. And you'll see that there's a number of mods that you could put on your armor that will help out. But I think more importantly, there's going to be mods that you will put on your weapons that will help you tackle these types of enemies, because you're going to have to, like I said before, pick and choose, say who's going to run what type of rounds on certain weapons, and only certain weapons will take certain type of weapon mods that will help you take down these enemies. And you saw, I just picked up an Arc Explosive Finisher mod. Well, that's one of the sources, is when you get a world drop, a world engram to drop, you can get a mod. Now, Banshee is going to be selling two mods, and I asked one of the developers, and they were not 100% sure, but they said that Banshee's stock should rotate daily with two different mods. We don't know the cost, we don't know what the trade-in value is going to be, we don't know how the enhancement prisms are going to work, and also the ascendant shards. We're going to talk about that in a little bit here, but you guys let me know in the comment section. If it does rotate daily, I can make a 30-second video every single day at reset. Hey, this is what he's selling, buy it or not buy it. You let me know in the comment section. Would you want me to do something like that for you guys? Here we go, Armor 2.0. Now, all armor, legendary and exotic, dropped after October 1st will drop as Armor 2.0. Let me freeze frame this thing right here. So, when you get a piece of armor, be it planetary armor, new Shadowkeep armor, Season of the Undying, it's all going to follow this format right here. You're going to get base stats, which are off to the right, and then you're going to have an affinity to a specific element and also an energy level. So, we're looking here at this Warlock Hood, Dreambane Hood, and it has one energy. Now, to get the most use out of this thing, we want to upgrade this thing and make it a masterwork and get it to 10 energy. And this way, we could slot in a whole bunch of different mods and, well, be the most effective in whatever activities we're doing. Now, to upgrade it, you're going to need legendary shards, you're going to need glimmer, and you will need these enhancement prisms when you get towards the end, and for the final one, an ascendant shard. Now, Banshee, when we saw in his inventory, looks like he'll be selling those two final items, the ascendant shard and also those enhancement prisms. However, it also showed in the Nightfall ordeal directory that those are some of the rewards for completing those things, and who knows where else we'll find them. So here I am just kind of preparing for going into that 950 and just kind of picking and choosing, well, what kind of mods do I want to put on this helmet? But let's stay on the right-hand side for a little bit. So once I masterworked everything, look at the stats. Well, the stats all went up. So first thing you need to look at is when you get a piece of gear to drop, be it anything, anything legendary or even exotic, look at the stats. We have mobility, resilience, and recovery, just like we did in Destiny 2 for year 1 and 2. However, they did bring back intellect, discipline, and strength from Destiny 1. If you're new to Destiny 2, intellect is how quickly you will get your super back. Discipline is all about how quickly you get your grenade back. And strength is all about how quickly you get your melee back. So certain mods, you're going to see a little symbol for an element. Like here I've got a piece of solar gauntlets, and you can see a number of the mods only show the solar symbol on them. That means that I can only equip that specific mod on a solar piece of armor. Now here I am working on a void piece here, and well, you see a number of mods that have a little void symbol on them. Actually, not that many. The rest don't have any symbol. So, here's all the void ones, right? So, the way it works in a nutshell is certain mods will have an affinity to certain pieces of armor, and then the ones that do not have any elements, you can pretty much put them on anything you want. And what I mean by anything is like this unflinching large arms and unflinching rifle aim that you're seeing right now. I could have put that on a chest piece that was not void, but anything that has the little void symbol on, it's got to go on a piece of armor that has the little void symbol where you masterwork the piece of gear. Next up, I've got my boots here, and you're going to notice as you progress through your different types of pieces of armor, well, they all have different things they do or different mods that you could put on them. Like, typically, your gauntlets are going to be all about reloading, right? Boots are going to be about scavenging. Unflinching is usually going to come on the chest pieces, and you'll get the hang of it once this all comes out. I got to admit, it was a bit overwhelming having all of these at my disposal, but at the same time, man, it is going to be a blast. Well, creating builds. They're really going the MMO route with this game. And so if you're a casual, don't be intimidated by it. It's all the mods are pretty self-explanatory. They'll tell you what they do and you think, okay, can this benefit me in playing the game? And you throw it on. When you see a piece of gear, well, the first thing you want to take a look at before you even think about upgrading it to a masterwork is look at the base stats. Look at the intellect. Look at the discipline. Look at the strength. Look at the recovery. Look at all that sort of stuff. And see if you want to keep that piece of gear. Now, moving on to weapons, you can see here I have overload rounds and anti-barrier rounds. These mods came from my seasonal artifact. Now here's where you want to have the conversation with your fire team members as to, well, we're doing the 950, we've got those unstoppable champions, and we have the barrier champions. So you want to talk with each other and say, well, who's going to run what? And certain weapons will take certain seasonal artifact mods. Same thing with the armor. You can have certain armor pieces that will take certain seasonal artifact mods, but you need to make a choice. You need to sacrifice what other regular mods, be it void affinity mods, solar affinity mods, arc affinity mods, the plain old mods that don't have any affinity, well, what's really going to benefit you within this particular ordeal, Nightfall Strike. So when using this auto rifle here with my anti-barrier rounds, well, it gives you the prompt on the left-hand side of the screen that I have my anti-barrier rounds active. If I switch to another weapon that does not have it, well, you won't see that anymore. Also, look underneath the arc symbol on this auto rifle. You also see that little triangle. Well, that's the symbol for anti-barrier. Now, when you see a barrier champion, well, they'll have that same little symbol over their head, which means you should do damage to them in case someone else on your fire team does not have those types of rounds. Now, here's a picture of, let's say, some arrowheads, right? Here's some overload arrows. Damage by fully drawn arrows causes disruption, delaying ability energy regeneration, and lowering combatant damage output. Strong against overlord champions. Now, I did not have this, or I did not have that type of mod on my auto rifles or submachine guns, so I was staying away from those enemies until their shields were down, and then using my weapons on them. But if you watched my video from yesterday where I went over all of the mods from the seasonal artifact, yeah, not all weapons can take seasonal artifact mods. It only is certain archetypes, submachine guns, hand cannons, auto rifles, arrows, things like that. So some final thoughts and first impressions. I loved it. I thought it was a lot of fun. I think it's going to put a lot of thought process into your builds if you're into that type of thing. And someone like myself who love games like The Division, Division 2, and even Anthem for maybe the first week or two. No, I'm sorry. Well, maybe first couple of weeks. I like spending time going through my gear and really specking out my gear for certain activities. And I think adding that element to Destiny, I think, is a brilliant idea. And for the casuals, don't be afraid, guys. You know, just look at the mods. Look at the intellect, discipline, and strength. You know, don't be so fixated that you have six different stats that you need to have all perfect. It's never going to be perfect. You're never going to get all perfect gear. We chased it all in Destiny 1, and it was very difficult to get. I would say focus on intellect and discipline, because you want supers and you want grenades. If you're a hunter, well, actually, Titans like melees, and Hunter Night Stalkers like melees, because they want their smoke back. But, don't get overwhelmed. That's really where I'm trying to go with this thing. If you're a casual or don't want to get into the whole building thing, that's fine. Just take a see what mods you have. Go buy Banshee when you have time, or watch my videos and check out what he's selling and say, oh, I like that. Major resist. You know what? That's going to come in handy when I do the Nightfall or speed reloading with, enhanced hand. No, actually, that comes from the seasonal artifact. Sorry, end of the video where I babble and I have no script anyway. But you know what I'm talking about, guys. Just take a look at the mods and see if it benefits your style of gameplay and go from there. So I'm going to let the full strike roll out. I'm going to cut some parts here and there because we did wipe a few times. I will also bleep out some dialogue because there is, well, a hint at one of the major spoilers in terms of what Eris has found, that mind-blowing secret that I keep teasing and I want you guys to experience on October 1st. And yeah, I cannot wait until you guys see it. And I'll be streaming on October 1st on day one. And that's it, guys. So leave me a good old hashtag made it to the end if you made it this far, and you can enjoy the gameplay in the background. If you would like to further support this channel and become a channel member, join our channel member Discord, join the Mesa Army Clan. And the Mesa Army Clan got so big, we have a second regiment now. The first regiment filled up with 100 people. Now we have, we're working on the second 100 now. We've got an awesome Discord. We've got some LFG going on. People are getting raids done, getting some PvP done, competitive. I'm going to be doing the raids with you guys on PC. And yeah, we've got we're building an awesome community for you guys here, the Mesa Army. That's it, guys. Drop a like on this video only if you see fit. Follow me on Twitter at Mesa Sean. Check out my stream. Usually know it's on YouTube, but that's it. I am out of here like Vladimir.
I do, Guardian. The hatred as pure and abundant as sunshine, soaking through your skin. Ash Ladoon knows what you are, what you've done. She watched you cut through Crota, Oryx, Omnigal, and she is eager to return that pain.
Thank you. down.
Here she comes.
It's over. Hashladun is dead.
This is a relief to hear. But Hashladun's presence is no coincidence. The Hive must have grander ambitions for influences. Return to me. There is much to discuss.